Do you know the most common signs of a vitamin B12 deficiency? Well, in this video, I will share how you know you have a vitamin B12 deficiency. If you've got questions and comments, I'd love to hear from you. Leave them below. I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor and best-selling author of the Healthy Millionaire series. So how do you know you have a vitamin B12 deficiency? Well, most times this is something that's evaluated in your blood work. So often you have to ask your doctor if your doctor is not already checking for this in your blood work. But what's funny about the blood work is that it's not always giving you the right parameters for what is a healthy B12 level. So for instance, here in Canada, what is deemed normal would be between 138 and 652 picomoles per liter. And unfortunately, I think, in my opinion, that those numbers are way off. We shouldn't have a much higher B12 because the B12 vitamin is so important for so many aspects of our overall health and our energy levels. And in some countries, like in Japan and some European countries, if you have anything less than 500 picomoles per liter, then supplementation is highly encouraged. So unfortunately, I think a lot of us here in Canada and in North America are suffering with low B12 and we don't even know it because our blood work will say that it's good, but it's not in fact good enough. So I usually say up in the 800s is where our B12 levels should be. So there's different stages of deficiency. So in stage one of a vitamin B12 deficiency, this would be that decline in the blood levels. At stage two of a vitamin B12 deficiency, the cells would become low in vitamin B12, and these would be the red blood cells. In stage three, we would notice that there is a high homocysteine levels, and the homocysteine is related to DNA synthesis, and that would be compromised if you're low in B12, but also high homocysteine is putting you at greater risk for cardiovascular disease because it has a negative impact on the arteries. And that's important. We want to protect our arteries. We want to keep our homocysteine levels low, and B12 helps to do that. Now in stage four, it would be macrocytic anemia, that meaning that the red blood cells become very big and have less ability to carry the oxygen in the right way. So this is a problem when we're talking about B12 deficiency. And historically, you know, most of us would not be deficient in B12. And why is that? Well, we were out and about in the farm with the animals and, sorry, I have to say it, with their poop and interacting, and we would have that natural exposure to vitamin B12. But because we don't live, you know, the simple life as much anymore, what happens is that we have now a B12 deficiency. We have over-sanitation of our food stock and how we, you know, would have historically had contact with some of these organisms, and as well as the animals that we eat have less of this exposure because everything now is too clean. So I know it's interesting information. If you learn something new, please, you know, give me that big thumbs up. Also share this video with someone that you think may have a B12 deficiency or who you think would, you know, really appreciate and value the information that I shared. Leave your questions and comments below. I would love to hear from you. I'm curious where your B12 level is in your blood work. And you know, in another video, I'm sharing ways and tips that you can get that B12 back to the levels where it should be. Thanks for joining me today. Remember to always take care of your good health and to do it naturally.